Hello, I'm Virginia Eskin, and I hope you'll join me for First Ladies of Music. Our series celebrates women who've carved out new territory for themselves, but they've left legacies that have influenced all who have followed. From as early as the 5th century, we know that there have been women composers and performers. In the past, many of these women pursued their art with no recognition, but their music proves that through the ages, women composers and performers were very creative. In First Ladies of Music, we'll show how much we owe these women, past and present, and you'll get to hear their music. Our focus today is on string and percussion. The performers are Maud Powell, Jacqueline du Pré, and Dame Evelyn Glennie. They're real trailblazers. Powell was a superb violinist, du Pré an incredible cellist, and Glennie is a true pioneer as a living composer-percussionist. We're going to begin the program with Maud Powell. Born in Peru, Illinois in 1867. At age 7, she began serious music studies with Professor Fickinger, who was a local music teacher. Maud wrote, "The earliest fiddlistic struggles I remember were getting up at 6:30 to practice, coming home from school, and practicing for another hour before supper." Another memory from Maud was, "My first public appearance was at a picnic. I borrowed a violin, played a composition, and all the people listened in wondering silence." In 1881, when Maud was 14, she and her family went to Leipzig. She graduated from the Leipzig Conservatory with a first-grade diploma when she was 15. The family then moved to Paris, where Maud studied at the Paris Conservatory, completing her training with Europe's greatest masters, Schrodick in Leipzig, Dankla in Paris, and the great Joseph Joachim in Berlin. She refused to be lured into a comfortable career in Europe. Her pioneering spirit preferred to face the challenges of the raw, uncultured American continent. In a similar way, Amy Beach went against the traditions of the time, and of course the two women eventually met, and Beach composed a beautiful work entitled Romance, which she dedicated to Maud. Here is this gorgeous piece. Joseph Silverstein is the violinist, and I'm playing the piano. Thank you. As you will have heard in the coda, Amy Beach invented a wonderful way of summing up a piece. And she does this in every work, defying the notion that women were delicate and weak. Amy decided, I think, to set the record straight. Here's an example of what I mean. Maud Powell was responsible for giving the American premieres of the most important violin concertos ever composed. Tchaikovsky, Saint-Saëns, Sibelius, Bruck, and Dvorak, who dedicated his concerto to Maud's teacher, Joachim, who was a good friend of Brahms. Dvorak is responsible for recognizing the value of Negro spirituals and went on to include some in his New World Symphony. Let's hear a charming recording of four American folk songs played and arranged by Maud Powell. This is an old recording, as you will hear.
Thank you.
You've just heard a vintage recording by Maud Powell of Old Kentucky Home, Old Black Joe, Shine On, and Kingdom Coming. Maud Powell is such a standout because of her incredible energy and ability to do it all. She eventually marries, and she's a suffragette. Must have had good health because she was a true missionary for music. Ironically, Maud Powell's life of achievement ended the same year that the 19th Amendment granting national suffrage to women was ratified. Upon her death on January 8th in 1920, the New York Symphony paid tribute to this supreme and unforgettable artist. She was not only America's great master of the violin, but a woman of lofty purpose and noble achievement, whose life and art brought to countless thousands inspiration for the good and the beautiful. We now turn from a great violinist to a great cellist. Jacqueline du Pré was born in England in 1945. She was a child who couldn't resist music. At an incredibly early age, she heard her older sister play, and she wanted to play too. But for Jackie, it was always the cello. She started with lessons from her mother, who composed little pieces accompanied by illustrations, before beginning study at the London Violoncello School at the age of 5. Here's a piece Jacqueline would have played as a girl, and here she is now playing In the Woods by Dvorak, conducted by her husband, Daniel Barenboim, with the Chicago Symphony Orchestra. Listen to how she drags the melody so touchingly, and it certainly helps to have your husband conducting, and he certainly indulges her need for the variations of tempo.
Thank you.
You just heard Jacqueline du Pré playing the little Dvorak piece In the Woods, accompanied by her husband, Barenboim, and the Chicago Symphony Orchestra. You are listening to First Ladies of Music with Virginia Eskin over the WFMT Radio Network. Welcome back to First Ladies of Music with Virginia Eskin over the WFMT Radio Network. Today we're talking about violinist Maud Powell, cellist Jacqueline du Pré, and percussionist Evelyn Glennie. Women who changed the playing field. We'd love to hear your comments about this program and suggestions that you might have for future programs. Please email us at ladies@wfmt.com. Jacqueline du Pré met pianist Daniel Barenboim on New Year's Eve in 1966, and they were married in Jerusalem in June in 1967. It was said at the time that theirs was not a marriage, but in fact a merger. As we learn about these extraordinary women musicians, we want to throw some light on the women who, from behind the scenes, created a platform for other women. They were wealthy, educated, but the conventions of the time forbade anything like a career on any stage. Jeanette Thurber was one of these women who helped by establishing a major music school in Cincinnati, and other women helped in New England Conservatory and also in Oberlin, Ohio. As Professor Judith Tick of Northeastern University in Boston has written, tradition encouraged women to take up music and then discouraged them from any meaningful career. Jacqueline du Pré seized upon the music of her countryman, Sir Edward Elgar, and his sensuous cello concerto suited her to a T. She made it her signature piece and, in fact, made her debut at the Royal Festival Hall playing this concerto. Until she made it her own, it had always been avoided by cellists. Du Pré was able to infuse so much passion into the work, and this is a sign of a great performer. She was able to stand in the shoes of the dead composer and make it a really living thing. No cellist before du Pré had dared to play with such strength and originality. And her stage appearance helped too. The flowing blonde hair, beautiful gowns, made a very glamorous addition to the concert stage. Here is Jacqueline du Pré playing her heart out with the opening of Elgar's cello concerto.
Thank you.
You just heard Jacqueline du Pré playing Elgar's Cello Concerto, conducted by Sir Malcolm Sargent with the New Philharmonia Orchestra. Tragically, du Pré was diagnosed with multiple sclerosis in October 1973. She recorded her last studio album of sonatas by Chopin and Franck in 1971 and spent much of her final years as a teacher. She died in London in 1987 at the age of 42. Our third trailblazer is Dame Evelyn Glennie, a Scottish virtuoso percussionist. Born in 1965, Glennie has been profoundly deaf since the age of 12. This hasn't stopped her from a major career. By combining superb technique and astonishing musicality, she creates performances of such vitality that they constitute a new art form. She's the first person in musical history to successfully create and sustain a full-time career as a solo percussionist. In 2007, Evelyn Glennie was made a Dame Commander of the British Empire for her services to music, and to date, she's received approximately 80 international awards. When I first watched her play in Providence, Rhode Island, because of her deafness, I thought she was faking it in some way. I just couldn't believe what I was seeing. I discovered that she focuses on the conductor with his baton, and he's the gate through which she's able to stay connected with the orchestra. I can say that I found this astonishing, but seeing is believing. Let's listen to Dame Evelyn in a wonderful piece called Sizzle, written by a friend of hers, Margaret Brower. This piece was commissioned by the Women's Philharmonic Orchestra in San Francisco. Here's Sizzle.
Thank you.
You just heard Sizzle by Margaret Brower. It was played by Dame Evelyn Glennie with the Royal Liverpool Philharmonic, conducted by Gerard Schwartz. She's commissioned over 147 works from the world's most eminent composers, and she composes music herself. Glennie makes a very colorful appearance on stage wearing specially designed outfits, which she changes for each piece, enabling her to dash barefoot about the stage on a specially constructed catwalk, banging, crashing, attacking the instruments as she cavorts wildly. Here's the Concerto for Percussion by Mio, and it was composed in 1930, long before Evelyn was born. She's accompanied by the Scottish Chamber Orchestra. Paul Daniel is conducting.
Thank you.
Since Dame Evelyn is always on the watch for the bizarre and the unusual, her choice of Michael Dougherty is a natural. Born in 1954 in Iowa, he's one of the most performed and commissioned living American composers. Here's a very unusual piece. It is called Unidentified by Michael Dougherty. He wrote it for Evelyn and the National Symphony and refers to the unidentified flying object crash in the New Mexico desert when large scraps of metal were discovered. What happened to those alien objects? Michael Dougherty uses a xylophone and 8 pieces of unidentified metal to create a sound picture of this happening. Here's Evelyn again. Listen to what a woman can do with scrap metal. Unidentified. That was Unidentified by Michael Dougherty, conducted by Marin Alsop with the Colorado Symphony Orchestra. Dame Evelyn has a gigantic sense of humor, and she loves to indulge it. She plays the great Highland bagpipes and has her own registered tartan known as the Rhythms of Evelyn Glennie. Speaking of rhythms, here she is playing the Maple Leaf Rag by our very own Scott Joplin. You just heard the Maple Leaf Rag played by Dame Evelyn Glennie with the National Philharmonic Orchestra. Ray Russell was the conductor. I hope you've enjoyed our program on these three very distinctive women, and you'll join us again on First Ladies. First Ladies of Music with Virginia Eskin is produced by Valerie Henderson for the WFMT Radio Network. Steve Robinson is the executive producer. Our engineer is Noel Flatt. We'd like to thank Northeastern University for its generous support, and also thank Alice Abraham, who's the librarian at WGBH Radio in Boston. I'm Virginia Eskin, inviting you to join me again next time for First Ladies of Music, when we'll bring you a program on American women composers from the turn of the century. We would love to hear from our audience, and our email address is ladies@wfmt.com. This is the WFMT Radio Network.